Now, module number one, some part of it is remaining, which I will cover once I complete module number 6.1. Okay, the moment I complete 6.1, I'll again go to 1.1. 2.2, 2.1 is completely complete. Okay, 4.1 is complete, everything is complete. 4.2, today we are going to see instrumentation amplifier IC AD620. Then next lecture will cover mono sort multivibrator. And also next lecture will be starting with 6.1. Okay, so majority of the portion, I can say 60% of the portion for ISC is complete in semester exam. Okay, any doubts in this? So we are fully complete. Yeah, okay, fine. So I thought that I will start with, you know, little bit of brief key what we are going to do in the next few weeks. So again, I repeat, today we are going to study instrumentation amplifier AD620 and a little bit of sawtooth waveform generator, because I have not taught that. I have just given you the video. So anyways, I will be covering roughly that. So 4.2, only mono sort multivibrator will be left, which I will cover in this this Thursday. And also I'll be starting with 6.1. Okay, after I complete 6.1, I'll again jump back to 1.1. and complete this input bias and, you know, offset currents and all that. You know, very first lecture I've given you the car analogy. Do you all remember? Even if we don't know what's inside the car, we can still drive the car, right? We don't know how does the car operate, you know, the engine operates and all that. Still, you know, if we can control the car. So we were controlling the op-amp like this. But we should know, I mean, you all also agree that if something happens to the car, we should know little bit of insides also of the car. We should know how the engine possibly works, what is the coolant, you know, how is the gear mechanism working. So you should have a little idea. So that is what we will dive in into module number 1.1. And we will be seeing into the op-amp little bit. We'll see what's inside it and how do we, you know, control various parameters. So that I will cover after, you know, 6.1. And lastly will be 6.2, which will be 555 timer. Okay, so with this, let me start with today's content. Okay, where it is? Yeah, so lecture number 22 will be this. Now, I hope that all of you we have covered this topic before. Three op-amp instrumentation amplifier. Okay, so tell me, what's the advantages of three op-amp instrumentation amplifier? One by one. I am expecting the answers right now.
High input impact.
Yeah, very good.
Does not hold the pitching scale. Does not load the preceding stage.
Yeah, it is, does not load the preceding stage. Correct. Next. You will see, okay, fine, I think I will, you know, a little bit help you out, accelerate your answers. Let me go to simulation of this directly. And I think that from there I will be, I mean, this is the same circuit. Okay, this is the same circuit which I've given over here. And we have done numericals based on this, and we have relatively, you know, asked some questions also based on this. So basically, let me explain you, let me take you back around, you know, few lectures before. So this was a bridge circuit. And you know, this RD was some temperature sensor. So this 1.01 indicated some temperature. And this difference between the bridge and unbalanced bridge, we are going to amplify the, you know, in the with the help of three op-amp instrumentation amplifier. So when we did that, you see, this was 7.5, this was 7.53. So it was subtracting this. The difference between the two inputs was fed as the input of the input to the instrumentation amplifier. And the output was around, you know, gain of 10 was set for the instrumentation amplifier. So what I mean to say is you can set a relatively low gain as well as you can set a gain of 1000 also. I guess you know that. I mean, we can select a gain till 5000 also. So very, very small difference between the input signal also can be amplified very, very faithfully. Correct. And it also works with AC signals, DC signals, both. But there are various advantages that it does not load the preceding stage and it has high CMRR, you know, all those advantages we have. But do you think there could be a little disadvantage also somewhere? Anyone? What could be the disadvantage?
Circuit okay. is complex.
Not complex. It is not complex. If you call this complex, let me show you the inside of an op-amp. 741 op-amp inside, if you see, this is nothing. Complex is not a reason. Yeah, I mean, looks wise, if you see, according to you, it is a complex. Okay, let me rephrase my question. In order to change my gain, I mean, the gain of this instrumentation amplifier depends upon the first stage, correct? And the second stage. Yes or no? And that means what? My entire gain depends upon these seven registers. 1, 2, 3, 4, R1 to R4, and RG and R3A and R3B, correct? So it all depends upon these seven registers. Now, if you go inside your lab, what guarantee you will give that the two registers are same? There is no guarantee. It depends upon the tolerance. I mean, we have put over here 10 kilo ohms. But when you measure in a multimeter, actually, if you go in the lab and measure in a multimeter, that will not be 10 kilo ohms. That will have some tolerance. That might be between 9.9 and 10.1 kilo ohm. So no two resistance will remain same. That's what the problem is. It gives you all the advantages, but in order to set a precise gain, we need to precisely set the value of these seven resistors. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's what the need of monolithic instrumentation amplifier IC is. AD620. So that what if we can replace this entire 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier just with a single IC, and in order to change the gain, we will just change a single external resistor. If we can do that, I mean, that will solve the purpose. Now remember the circuit, huh? This is 7.5, this is 7.537, and this is 373 millivolt. Okay, if we can replicate, if we can apply my inputs like this and I get the same output, that means I can replace this 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier. Okay, so here it is, what is written over here. So that's what you can read it out. So in the above circuit, we have learned that to set a fixed precise gain in 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier, we need 7 external resistors of closely matched and accurate values, which is never practically realizable. That's why we go for instrumentation amplifier IC. Okay, now I will be opening a circuit. Let me open that in LTSpice. So I'll keep this circuit in place, intact. And let me open the circuit now. Okay, so this is the yellow color thing is my instrumentation amplifier IC. And this is my bridge circuit, the very own bridge circuit, which we have seen. So let me simulate this. See, you have 7.5, this is the same voltage, and you remember you are getting around 373 millivolts only, close to, correct? So it is giving you same output, but with its gain is changed only via single resistor R1. That's it. No other thing is required. Actually, this is RG only, actually, but it's okay. It's externally called as RG only. So that's how we get it. So just by using a 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier, we can eliminate that 7 resistors we have to adjust. Here we just require one resistor. Yeah? Any doubts in this? Hello?
No, sir.
Okay, here again you have to apply the same power supply. So basically it's an 8-pin IC. It's a very little bit costly IC. But I have said AD620. So actually in LTSpice there is no AD620. That's why it is. I have used the counterpart. I mean, let me just show you over here. Yeah. So basically what happens is AD620 is not available in LTSpice. So I have used exactly similar to AD620. So that is available in the form of LT1167. That is an instrumentation amplifier. This is a single resistor gain programmable instrumentation amplifier. Okay. So here, in order to set the gain of 10, we'll just use this you know, instrumentation amplifier. Now you all will be thinking, why not use a normal, you know, differential amplifier? We have already seen the disadvantages of differential amplifier, correct? We cannot use a differential amplifier over here. Differential amplifier also will amplify the difference between the two inputs. Instrumentation amplifier is also doing that, but with much, much superior control. It will not load the pre-preceding stage and all that. Here, the value of RG will be set by this formula. 49.4 kilo ohms divided by G minus 1. So let's say if you want a G of gain of 10, then the value of RG will be evaluated by this formula, and it came out to be 5.49 kilo ohms. Okay. And we have just now seen that the same output we got it in case of an instrumentation amplifier. Let me just show you. Over here, if you see carefully, this was TOPAM instrumentation amplifier, almost same, 373.09 millivolt, and here we are getting 373.06 millivolt. So it's almost same only, correct? And now let me proceed. So that means if I want to change the gain to a very low value or very high value, I can just do that by changing one resistor. Okay, now let us explore this further. Okay, let me go back to the PDF. Okay, so here Vout is coming out to be same. That's what we have seen before. Now, this normally is asked for a, you know, short note type thing. So that's what I've written over here. Let me just expand it a little. Yeah, this is my connection diagram. It's the same as you can see. This is 8620. This is my LT1167. It's exactly, both are same only. Okay, only thing is made by different manufacturers. So this is my RG, 1 and 8 is my RG, means I can connect my resistor in between these two pins. It's a very famous IC for a biomedical applications, for ECG monitoring and all that. Shortly we will see that. Okay, so here are my two inputs, 2 and 3, written as minus IN and plus IN, and minus VS and plus VS are my, you know, power supplies, minus and positive. This pi is my reference. Normally we connect it to ground, and my RG, and between 1 and 8 I'll connect the external resistor. Okay, now these are the description of that IC, 8620. It's a low cost, high accuracy instrumentation amplifier that only require one external resistor to set the gain from 1 to 10,000. I was talking about 5,000, but it can change the gain from 1 to 10,000 actually. It is a monolithic instrumentation amplifier. That means the instrumentation amplifier is built in within the IC. Okay. And these are some few features. The supply current here is around 1.3 milliampere max. Okay, this is important point. The gain selection. So basically 8620, the gain is resistor programmable by RG. So it is connected between pin number 1 and 8. And it is offering accurate gains up till, you know, 0.1 to 1% resistor tolerance. Okay, so let's say if you want a gain of 1, that means you want to pass the same thing. I mean, you just add a buffer. You want to, you know, make use this instrumentation amplifier as a buffer. So you don't connect anything at the, at over here. RG, you don't connect. You left the key, left the terminals 1 and 8 open. So that will give you a gain of 1. Okay, so right now this is my table conversion. That means selecting the value of RG, particular value of RG, I can select a particular value of gain. Right now the gain was 10, and 5.49, as you can see. We have selected a resistor 5.49. I mean, what you can do is you can put this inside a calculator, and for a different values of gains, we can calculate the different values of resistor. One of you can verify one of the values, okay, later on. Now we have chosen 5.49, so it was giving a calculated gain of 9.998. So that's what we got over here. We got almost a gain of, almost a gain of 10. Okay, 9.998. Fine. Now let me show you, this is not only the application of, you know, the 8620, it can act as an AC or a DC amplification. So let me show you DC amplification. Actually, DC amplification you have seen only, right? So, I mean, if I apply here, let me show you. this is the okay. This is DC amplification. Basically, here I am just amplifying. Someone is trying to speak. Okay, yeah, good. Okay, here I'm amplifying 10 millivolts signal. I'm trying to amplify 10 millivolt signals. And I'm getting here, 10 millivolts and converted into 100 millivolts, as you can see very clearly. Right? So this is my, DC amplification. Now let me change the resistor in front of you and show it to you. So which value do you want? Should I increase it to 49.9 where I get a gain of around 1000? Correct? So let me change that to 49.9. So will it work? Let's see. Yeah. Does anyone has a calculator now, right now? Hello? Someone can check, please? Whether we are getting accurate answer or no. So input is around 9.9, around 10 millivolt. You multiply that by 991. So you will get this minus 9.9, correct now? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so you can see, for very small input voltages also still it is amplifying. So what I'm doing over here I've applied the DC voltages, correct? Here I've applied my DC voltages and still I'm getting around, DC amplification. And this is around a gain of 1000. So it's working still. Now let me show you AC amplification also. So this is my AC amplification. Let me close other circuits. Okay, so here is my AC amplification. So here I've applied 10 millivolt AC signal. And let's see how much would I get. I have applied a gain of 10. So here is my input and here is my output. Actually, here I've applied 49.9 ohms. So 49.9 ohms corresponds to which gain? 991. So you will get a gain of around 1000. So that means close to 9 point something. 9.9 you should get the output peak amplitude. So if I place it over here, I'm getting 9.87. So you see input is around 10 millivolt and output I'm getting 9.87. Okay. And if I change it to 49.4 kilo ohms, this will change to gain of 10. See. So this is 10 millivolt and here it is around. Let us check that. Yeah, 19.97. So it's almost close to 20. And the peak value over here is around, 10. So gain of, peak value is 10. So you are getting a gain of, this is 20 millivolt and you're getting 40. So how much the gain will be over here? Okay, this is 20 millivolt peak to peak. Definitely. Yeah, correct. This is 10 millivolt peak. So 20 millivolt peak to peak. So you're getting almost, how much? 49.4 I have took. Let me take it. 5.94, sorry. 5.49, sorry. So this will give me the gain of proper 10. Okay. Okay, I'll simulate it again. Yeah, this will give me proper gain of 10. So you see input is 10 millivolts peak. Output is around 100 millivolt, as you can see very, very clearly. What I want to show you all is this IC. You can apply AC signals at the input, DC signals at the input, differential signals, single mode signals. It will still work with everything. Now let me show you certain applications of it using the data sheet. Now let me just complete this part. So did you understand by changing one resistor, we can set a very low gain, as low as around gain of 1. And as high as around 10,000, right? So these are some features of the IC 8620. Y'all can just go through it. So it's clearly written in point number 3. It has high performance than 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier. Wide power supply range. So it can you know, work with plus or minus 2.3 to 18, plus or minus 18 volts. So these are some advantages. CMRR is around 100 dB. And, you know, excellent DC performance. You know, this input offset voltage, input offset drift, input bias current, these all things, you know, we will talk about when we'll discuss, again, come back to module number 1.1. That is looking into your car, inside the car, knowing the engine, knowing the gearbox. So that is, we will, we will cover this topic. Anyone know what does you mean by DIP package? DIP means single, dual. Hello, anyone knows?
Dual inline.
Dual inline package.
Okay, fine, very good. It has 120 kilowatts bandwidth. What do you mean by that? What do you mean by this bandwidth? Meaning of this statement, 120 kilowatts bandwidth means what? For a gain of 100, that means I can operate my amplifier, my instrument is an amplifier, below this 120 kilowatts, it will work fine. If I try to go beyond 120 kilowatts, it will not function properly. And these are some of the applications of instrumentation amplifier IC, bait scales, ECG, instrumentation, transducer interface, data acquisition system, process control, battery powered and portable equipments. Okay, so it requires in that. Have you heard of pacemakers which are, you know, implanted wherever the heart is not pumping the blood properly? So it is, you know, inserted inside a human, you know, body wherein it is, you know, helping in the pumping of the heart. So that is battery powered, a portable battery powered application. One example I've given you. Now let me show you an actual data sheet. Where is the data sheet of it? Acha, AD620. Okay. What happened? Okay. I have to open this. I mean, are you all following AD620? I mean, whatever I'm discussing now. If you all practice this LTSpice simulation, then only, I mean, I think this was one of the post labs in instrumentation amplifier. I mean, we have given a question based on this only. I hope you all have done that question.
Yes.
Correct?
Sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so you, I mean, you understand what do you mean by a data sheet, right? So if you type in Google, Analog Devices are the company which has manufactured it. It is a low cost, low power instrumentation amplifier. So in the exam, if it is asked as a, you know, as a numerical or that, and all these values have taken from there only. Okay. So we have, I mean, these all applications which I've written in the PDF is this only. So it is well suited for medical applications such as ECG and non-invasive blood pressure monitor. Okay. So that's the feature. Now these are the varieties available. Now this is the comparison of you know, 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier using 3 OP07s and AD620. You see the error is quite less in case of, you know, instrument, the 3 op-amp AD620, whereas in case of 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier, the supply current is a little bit on a higher level. So that is why it is a low power, you know, application device. I'll share this PDF, you can have a look. Now what I want to show you, these are all the characteristics. Okay, these are all the typical values. So normally these are the specification which you find in the data sheet. For various gain of 1, 10 and 100 and 1000, these are the various performance of different types of ADCs. Okay, fine. So all these things you will hear about it very soon. Output offset voltage, input offset voltage, input bias current, input offset current, all of that we will hear. Actually, I think you know what is CMRR, I guess. But other than that, you don't know. And I was always talking about a slew rate, right? See, it has come over here. Slew rate. So slew rate unit is volt per microsecond. Do anyone remember what is the slew rate?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so basically how fast my output can respond to the input changes, the measure of it is the slew rate. Now, yeah, these are things I wanted to go to. The applications part. these are the typical performances which you can have a look at. This is my normally my frequency curve. I mean, as you can see, what does this indicate that, you know, what I'll just spend a few minutes over here. I mean, a few seconds. So this is my frequency response. It's looking like a, you know, which filter it looks like. It looks like a low pass filter, basically. So it will pass low frequencies where the gain is almost constant. And this is a CMRR against frequency. So your CMRR will, you know, reduce if you operate at a higher frequency. So that is what it means. Okay, so let me just show you the applications. These are the various, you know, yeah, these are the operation. This is the inside of the instrumentation amplifier. The gain equation. Make versus buy. So make means making that 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier. Buying means, you know, that 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier IC which we are talking about. Okay. So haven't we talked about this bridge? I mean, yeah, correct. So this is make versus buy. I mean, we have seen using this, and now we are seeing using this AD620. So these are the typical performance parameters between AD620 and this is the 3 op-amp instrumentation amplifier. You can see the comparison. You can go through the comparison later on. So the errors are reduced in case of the AD620. Yeah, so this is basically a pressure monitor circuit that operates on a single 5 volt supply. So this is my example. You know, always I was talking about, you know, the bridge circuit. So this is my bridge circuit connected. And this is my typical application which will monitor my pressure measurement. Then there is a medical ECG. So this is, I guess you know what is an ECG. So they have a lot of electrodes which they place. Can you see this? I mean, is this visible? Everyone, a medical ECG monitor circuit. So here also you can see AD620 plays a major role. Obviously, you will require a high pass filter and a output amplifier also. But, you know, this is the, these are the leads which are kept either at the, you know, suitable positions so that you can measure the ECG signal properly. Okay. So these are the one of the typical, I mean, if you go in the higher semesters and do your project, so this can be one of the possible ECG monitoring system, can also be one of the possible projects. And AD620 plays a very important role over here. It's not about the gain it provides. It's not about that. It's about the very high input impedance and not loading of the preceding stage. That is very, very important. And just by setting one value of resistor, you can set any gain possible. So that's the typical application of it. And then you have few more applications. I wanted to show you all that. Just wait. I guess these are the applications which were available over here. These are the operating ranges, meaning this 8-pin package is operatable between minus 40 degrees Celsius to 85 degrees Celsius. Now you will say why that is important. If you go in European countries near Antarctica, there the temperatures are below, you know, minus 40 also. So there this ICs won't work. There also you require electronics, right? So, you know, basically you have to go for military range, and military range is much more, you know, minus 55, I mean even greater than that. So that's why we have this temperature ranges are extremely important. Okay, that's about the AD620 part. Any questions on this single register programmable instrumentation amplifier IC? Any questions on this? Or I can proceed ahead. No questions? Okay, I was showing you all that, you know, that LT, I have used this circuit, used this IC inside LT Spice, right? LT1167 series. LT1167. So that's the data sheet. I wanted to show you all is the same instrumentation amplifier which we are talking about. Here also we have 1 to 10,000. Okay. And here also we have a supply current of 1.3 max. So exactly the same. and we have these applications. See, this is your barometer. I mean, you might have, I don't know whether you might have heard of this barometer. So this is a barometer application in that. Pin configuration, as you can see, it's exactly the same. That's why I've used that example. LT116. These are some similar, I mean, you can see similar characteristics over here. Exactly the same. No difference at all. Again, you have a slew rate and everything. See here. So a little bit here and there, the differences are there, but all the performance and all, everything is remaining the same. Now,